Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophinet and welcome back to XCOM 2 in our Commander playthrough. In my rush at the end of the previous episode, because I was running out of time to record, I forgot a few things. So, first off,
I wonder if this is what it was like in the old days. Always on edge, ready for a fight on a moment's notice. Certainly keeps you on your toes.
So, in the Proving Ground, since we completed the Muton Autopsy, we have the Plasma Grenade project, and that would significantly boost our damage with our grenades. Sadly, that takes 5 days in the Proving Ground, so we're not going to have that for this mission and the next one either. But I'm going to set it up anyway, so we can have that going.
As soon as we're finished, Commander.
There we go. And now we have enough supplies left to buy ourselves the increased damage on the grenade launcher. So a larger radius to any launched projectiles, and we can propel them a lot further. So that's good either way. 75 supplies and 10 alloys. We have that in the bag. There we go. Don't think we need anything else. No. Okay, so let's head back to the bridge and start this guerrilla operations, because we have that big bad timer up there and I do want to get that out of the way. So, guerrilla operations. And then we were going for the rapid responses, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, we were going for the rapid responses in Operation Hammer Dragon, and we get a scientist from that as well. So, there we go. Do I still want this team? The two grenadiers might not be bad with the extra firepower, especially since their mag cannons have been improved. Let's see, do we have anything else I wanna give anybody? I think if I manage equipment and make armor available, there we go, and put that armor on Vinny, that should give us a bit of an edge. There we go, spider suit. Do we need the flashbang? I'm not exactly sure if we do, especially because we don't really have a use. It's good panic button, that is true. So we might actually do that. So let's swap out one of Geralt's grenades with a flashbang. There we go. Okay, so that's the squad we're gonna head out with. Humongous, Benito Buffon, Christoph Feinwood, Ulrich Edel, Geralt of Rivia, and then, of course, Vinny. Here we go. I've always found it funny, if you start this game up, you get a message that the developers don't condone any actions that you can perform in this game. So, in the case of a real alien invasion, Fireaxis does not condone you starting a resistance and shooting up the place, just so that's clear.
We got a tip that the aliens have been moving remote data collection vaults on Advent transport vehicles through this region. We've got an opportunity here to seize material critical to the alien project we picked up on, and it's the only way we're going to slow them down. Move in and secure the area. Eliminate all hostile contacts and recover the assets.
So that's again why we have two specialists on this mission. So we neutralize all enemy targets, easy. But we need to get an item from an advent vehicle. So that's where the hacking will come in handy. The Slums District Needle Park in Sapporo. I don't think we ever went there. Although I do like the name of this operation, Operation Hammer Dragon. Let's hammer this down, right? Here we go. Dropping down. Six guys again. There we go.
Menace 1-5, we've got a bead on the Advent Data Vault near your position. Be advised, self-detonating charges are in place at the target. Move to disarm and extract the package before its contents are destroyed.
Oh, I think he saw something already. I sent out Benito in front, but he saw something already. There's something inside. Oh, there we go. Okay, so we still need to kill a codex, if you're wondering. And oh, I didn't know that happened. So apparently if you hacked an officer once, codexes start spawning on the map as well, because there's one right next to the item. Interesting. So I don't need to hack the officer anymore. Which is good, of course. We only have 8 turns to get the item, but we don't need to extract in that time, and the vehicle is not that far ahead, so that's not that bad. So let's put everybody down. So everybody pretty clustered together, and then we're gonna put Vinny on an overwatch position. Do I push anybody further? Maybe I should. Spread out a bit.
Position confirmed.
So we can get a bead on them if we need to. Put you over here. And right over here next to the car. Pretty close together, but that's not really a problem for now. I could grapple. Yeah, over there.
Grappling!
Joops! And then we didn't spend any action, so now we can put him on overwatch. So they're moving inside of the building. So that's a trooper, an advanced officer, and a shield bearer. Who are gone now. Let's stand in front of the door.
Vado.
And just breach this building like you would in... Oh shit! That was not what I meant to do, but never mind. We could definitely blow this thing to hell, since all three of them are troopers, so... Huh. Maybe this is a good time to start... Because I didn't think they could see them through the door, but that might have been a stupid idea, because, well, we saw them through the door to begin with. Let's see. We could skulljack one, and we actually have a few shots in here. So the officer or the trooper we could take out immediately, but... Kistov is still in concealment, so we might want to save that if we can. Skull mine, the advanced trooper. And that's about it, apparently, can't I? Oh, I could skulljack the officer as well if I want to. But I don't know if that would spawn another codex, actually. I'm not really sure about that. Let's put Vrijer a bit closer, preferably on this wall. Hopefully not triggering the codex on the right there. Let's open up the door. And then let's see what we can do with that gas grenade now, shall we? Ooh, wow, look at that. That advanced grenade is really doing work. I could go for those two. I can't really involve the officer. So maybe gonna wait with that. Let's get that shot with the sniper first. So that's 82%. And that's 8 damage. So we need to do the full 8 damage to kill the thing. But never mind. Here we go. 7 damage. That's not bad, actually. Could have done a lot worse. And now we can actually kill him off with the grenade if we need to. So yeah, Vrijer, why not, eh? Gas grenade. Right in the middle of the building. Can I put that a bit further so I don't actually block my own exit that much? Yeah, there we go. So keep that to the left of the building. Here we go. I'm wondering if that shreds armor. I don't think it will because it's a gas grenade. That shouldn't... Oh no, it does. It actually shreds his armor. That is interesting. So you only have one armor point left, so might actually try to skulljack. Let's put you over here and yeah, skulljack the hell out of this guy. And stab in the face. I don't think he missed a single hack. So 58, a small cache of intel, and we would get... Oh, we don't get... Oh, shit. Unguarded access to Alien Network Central Data Repository. So that means we're gonna have trouble. We don't have that, but we have access. So that means we're gonna have a codex on our hand, probably. That wasn't the brightest idea. So we killed one thing to get ourselves another thing. But that's actually maybe because he spotted Skistov right now. Huh. Interesting. I was going to say I might be able to kill him, but How far can I go? If I go over here, I should get a flank shot, but I need to activate run and gun for that. So I'm best to put you... Let's try something else first. If I put Geralt here, and he doesn't see the Codex on the corner there, that should make everything okay. And otherwise I should... Yeah, okay. So I could use the flashbang, but I'm gonna save the flashbang for the other Codex. So if I put you over here...
I'm all over it.
So run and gun is active. If I put you over here... Ooh, he doesn't trigger him. Okay, 100% and 90% critical. So he might kill him in one shot. Here we go. Oh, 7 damage. That was actually pretty bad, because now this thing is gonna split. Yep, there he goes. So clone 1 to the back, but he halves his health.
The Codex is projecting multiple copies of itself into our dimension.
Yeah, indeed. So that's the first time we saw that cloning ability. So there's one still left over there, and he halves his health to do that, so he doesn't get more health. I think the positive thing here is that I can probably take them out, if I'm not mistaken. How far can you put your grenades, Mongo? Oh yeah, right in the building. Yeah, I'm not gonna take any risks, so take out the Codex over there now. With the grenade. There we go, 3 damage taken care of. And then we use... we need to use this grenade. What the? What? Huh? Oh, the trigger just, the hair trigger just activate? Yeah, okay, so I can shoot again. Okay then, never mind. Goodbye. And now he does 13 damage. Thank you very much. So there's the Codex brain. That's exactly what we need.
Excellent work, Commander. It appears some physical remnant of the Codex was left behind when it dissipated. Hopefully, it will provide some insight into the aliens' ongoing plan.
So that's good, because I think killing a Codex actually reduces the Avatar Project timer as well. So I'm going to put Geralt on Overwatch, because we still have another one. Oh, and I completely forgot about the Shield Bear. Yep, that was my fault. He's no longer poisoned, but if he wants to move, he's going to have to get through the poison. Is he going to do something? Yeah, poisoned again. So he's going outside. And there we have... Oh, he has friends. Oh, that was... Okay, never mind. Sectoid is down. So yeah, Sectoid... Wait, what? Sectoid down, but there's another one. So, a Codex and 2 Sectoids. The Sectoid is luckily dead. One of the Sectoids is dead, by the way. But now, we still have 3 enemies we need to take care of. I can put Benito over here. Which is a pretty good position for now. So let's do that. Nobody's on Overwatch, so that doesn't seem like that much of a problem. What else can we do? I think I could put Christoph, yeah, on another flanking position. So, therefore getting another shot at the Codex. I don't think that's a bad decision, so there we go. Okay. 82% chance. Not amazing, not the 100% I'd like, but nevertheless, Benito's shots aren't great, but I might use his combat protocol to finish someone off. What are your shots? 74 on the Sectoid and 56 on the Codex. So let's try a shot at the Sectoid. 74% chance. That should... 6 damage, okay. So that means I can kill him with a controlled shock. Anything else? Put Freyr a bit closer. Let's see what his shots are. If I can, I'd like to blow... Well, everybody up, but... Oh, you bastards. Just out of reach. So I could get the shield bearer. Okay, I'm gonna wait with that. So, okay, thank you. Let's put Geralt over here behind full cover. and then first try the flank shot with Christophe. If we can take out the Codex in one hit, that would be amazing. But otherwise he's gonna split and hopefully put himself in the crossfire of one of the grenades. So here we go. That was... was that a miss or what was it? 11 damage. Okay, that means he only has one health left. Can he split? Oh no, he just... oh, fuck. That is... an issue. That is so far away I can't even reach him, probably. Well, someone can see him. Can you see him? No, so the only one who can see him is probably Christophe over here, but Christophe lost his turn. Ooh, that is annoying. Let's focus on first killing the other two guys. So I think I'm just gonna keep this simple. Use a grenade on the shield barrier over there, dropping all his cover. The poison would probably kill them either way, but try not to kill too much cover. So there we go, that's pretty good. Give him hell, Ulrich, give him hell. I'm not gonna kill him with that, but... ooh, still 4 health left, but now he's out in the open, so someone else might have a shot at him. Geralt has a shot at the sectoid, but it's not great. And then we have Humongous, who I wanna put safely. I'm gonna put him in full cover anyway. So let's see. If I put you over here, you don't have... oh, you have a shot. 58 at the sectoid, but I can't guarantee kill the sectoid, so... oh, wait a second. Can I throw a grenade? Yeah, okay. That's perfect. Can I put him one further? Yeah. So that's gonna kill the shield bearer. So if I can focus first on killing the sectoid with a few 50% shots, that would be nice now, wouldn't it? 50-50. Ooh, one damage because of the stalk. Missed. And then we have Humongous a shot.
I'm running low on ammo.
58, so here we go. Car explosion, there we go. We killed the sectoid with the... it's actually the first enemy we killed with a car explosion. So probably Hugh missed and hit the car instead of the sectoid. But there we go. Let's use the frag grenade on the shield bearer over here, killing him. Definitely, because if it does 3 damage... okay, yeah, there we go. He's still poisoned, so he's gonna die at the end of our turn, which is now. There we go. So we only have a single codex left with one health, so he can't split up anymore, so he's gonna teleport over there, which gives him a nice flanking shot. Oh, he stopped. Yeah. Oh no, he does a... ooh, he does a psionic storm. That is great. Well, not that great, but yeah, there goes the car. I think that was the car. Don't know what happened there, but never mind. We have 5 turns to get there, so I'm gonna take this easy. We could still actually try and hit him with... that's actually not a bad idea. Yeah, let's try that, because you need a promotion. Nope, you just removed the cover. That was...
get it together.
Well, it's something at least. So now Christophe has a nice shot at him, because he didn't lose his gun in the process. So 99% chance. Yeah, okay, let's risk it. There we go, in the face, 12 damage. You should have done that first, but never mind.
You know that was good.
Yeah, I know that was good. So that... is that thing gonna dis... no, it's not gonna disappear. I'm actually also wondering if that car is still gonna explode. So let's put everybody out of the way of the explosion. Reloading a mag cannon takes a while, apparently. So that's that explodes. That's not a real physical explosion, so that doesn't actually harm anything. So that would just... well, it would damage us, of course, but it doesn't harm the environment. So now we need to get to the back of this car, pop it open, and we should be home free. Unless, of course, there's still one batch of aliens on the map, which I know there is, but... Ulrich, let's check it out. Do you see anything? Not another codex or something, because that would be very bad.
Get to the vault and disarm it before we run out of time.
Because, yeah, the item is rigged to explode, so if we fail to get there in time, he's gonna be really pissed. Let's put you over here and see what happens. Oh, shit. Jesus Christ, another codex. Okay. That's not that bad, actually. I could skull mine the trooper over here, even. But first, we have a tower here as well, so let's check that out first. Because Benito's out of bullets anyway, so he needs to reload, but we can check this. Gain control of a random enemy for 2 turns. 80%. Well, yeah. Because the negative effect is that enemy groups are being alerted to your position, so yeah, no. That's not even that bad, because that's probably the last batch of enemies. So yeah, hack that. Oh, yes! Yes, okay, that was very close. Whew! Gain control of a random enemy for 2 turns, so we need to remember that it's for 2 turns. I'm hoping it's the shield bear. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Does that mean we can actually use his ability? Oh, wait. Can't I? Oh, I can't use him yet. Well, that's not that bad, although I did put Benito in a really bad position there. That might have been bad. Who can you... And of course, you can only see the... No, you can see the codex as well. That's not gonna end well. Should have thought this through before I started... Yeah. Started using other stuff. Probably gonna have to handle this with one of... Well, the last grenade that Briar has. Let's put you over here and see what happens. Can I actually open the door from here? I can. So let's do that, because that doesn't take an action. So there we go. The thing is open. So now we have all the time in the world. Well, not all the time in the world, but frag grenade. Can I blow this entire thing to Kingdom Kong? I think I can, but do I want to? Because it's not gonna kill the Codex. But it is gonna put him out in the open. Are there explosives between those things, actually? I don't think it is. There are. Yeah, I'm just gonna blow this up and see what happens. So maybe Vinny can have a shot at whatever splits up. Here we go. And explode him. Now he's out in the open, but he's gonna split up. Which is actually better, because we can't kill the clones in one hit normally. Oh, that is bad. That is really bad, but I think now Vinny might have a shot at that one. Yeah, there we go. 62% shot. It's not much, but I'm gonna have to try it anyway. Please hit. Please hit. Please hit. That was a hit, but he grazed. He dodged. He dodged. He dodged, didn't he? So that means we're gonna have... Yeah. Oh, shit. I... think we're fubernuckled. Unless we still have a grenade. We still have a grenade. Can I? No. Is that completely in the way? Ah, that I should have seen that. Can't you lob that over there? Oh, that is so evil. Because if I could put it right over here, we could hit both of them. But yeah, that's at least one sectoid we can hit. I can't hit anything with you for now. So let's put him right over here. Okay, and then... How far can we put you? If I put you over here...
I can handle that.
We could try and take out... Because now we have a flank shot at the Codex, but it's not really that good. What can we do with a grenade? Oh, we can't kill that one with a grenade. So that means if I kill that one with a grenade and then the other one with a grenade, we might actually kill half of them. Because we have a slight chance that the Codex in the back might be distracted by the shield bearer we took over. So yeah, let's try that. So throw a grenade over there. That's at least one down, because the more Codex is on the map, because they all have abilities, of course. Wait, what is this? Wait. You have sight on someone, probably the trooper then. So let's reload. Oh yeah, because I moved you, of course. Yeah, never mind. That flashbang, how far does that... Ooh. Could I... No, I can't flashbang... But I can flashbang both the Codexes, which is good. Because they can't use abilities if they are flashbanged. But then again, I don't kill the one in the back and they have two shots at me. That's not good either. So let's blow up the one over there. What else do we have? Do we have anything else we can do? No, so that's our last action even. What's our shot at the trooper? 55. So yeah, I'm gonna use a grenade to kill that Codex over there. Yeah, I'm not gonna risk anything. Just kill him. Okay. Bit of a waste maybe, but at least we only have a Codex and a trooper to worry about now. So now we take control of the shield bear, so they're probably gonna try and attack him. Because he's still mind controlled. Okay, yeah, he's gonna attack his buddy. Oh no, oh no, oh no. He missed a flank shot, never mind. I was really convinced they were gonna try and fire at the shield bear. What the fuck? Yep, he's gonna do something. Okay, so that's three guys that can't use their weapons. Which is not that bad, because I should get access to the shield bear now. I think. Yeah, there we go. Does that actually work? Project an energy shield around nearby allies and yourself. That would be nice, wouldn't it? What are your damages? 5 to 6. So if I could put you right over... Don't. I'm going to put you right in the open because I don't want you to have that good of a cover. So let's put you over here. There we go. So he can see, yeah, he can see the item.
This is Avenger. We have positive confirmation of the target package. Move to acquire.
Yes, indeed. Move to acquire. And then we're going to fire 70%. Your shots are really bad. But I can't give anybody shields either way, so let's just fire at you. Yeah, just fire at your buddy. 7 damage. That was actually not that bad. Could use a grenade to finish those guys off. So let's put Benito to the back of the truck here and let him hack the thingy. Yeah, hack the thingy. That always sounds good. Hacking thingies is always preferred. So let's hack chest.
Access on system.
Yep, accessing the system, hopefully getting a hacking boost. That would be really nice, because that's one of the rewards you can get from a treasure chest like this. Delays the current dark event project by 2 weeks, or research time on the current tech reduced by 50%. I think we're researching the mech, if I'm not mistaken, and that's pretty much done already. So let's just delay the current dark events by 2 weeks. 99%, that should be no problem. We're really unlucky lately. Because that's not going all that far. So there we go, disarmed.
Troppo facile.
And now we still need to take out a few
status
enemies, don't we?
Confirmed. The charges are inactive and the package is secure.
So 4 damage on that thingy over there. And we still need to... Oh, but I could use a flashbang. That is actually a pretty good idea. So let's put everybody outside of the blast radius. I'm gonna have to check this, that the blast radius isn't bigger than I think it is. Let's put you on the side of this pillar. I think that's, yeah, that should be outside the blast radius.
Okay, shaboosh.
Ooh, and we still have a shot at the trooper. That is not all that bad, but I think we can do better. Let's put this stuff over here.
No problem, boss.
So all out of the blast radius. And then of course we could shoot, but yeah, we don't have any ammo left. Briar is pretty much out of ammo as well. Let's start off with the easy thing. I'm gonna just blast these guys with a flashbang. I don't think we are affected by flashbangs, by friendly flashbangs, but just to be sure, I'm gonna put it right over there. Flashing pretty much everything. That also stops the abilities of the Codex, so that should allow us to take a shot at him, actually. I could reload Vryer and then try and take a shot, but I don't think his shots would be that nice. Wait. Oh, I don't need to reload you. That is handy. Because then I'm going to put you right over here. Yep, there we go. In a nice flanking position on the Codex. 89% for some reason. But never mind. Let's blast this thing to hell through the window. And a bunch of bullets in your face. Did you seriously miss a 81% shot? God damn it, Friar. Okay. 8 protocol, that's not gonna help anybody, so let's just reload. And then let's fire away at the advanced trooper with a sniper rifle. I think it's a bit of overkill, but never mind. Blammo! And that was even a critical, so 9 damage. Now I'm wondering if we lose the shield bearer already. So let's reload you as well. But I'm wondering if this is the second turn that we can control him, because we only controlled him for one. Yeah, okay, for one turn. There we go. And there that goes. Nobody got hurt. And then... is anything gonna happen? Is the Codex gonna attack the shield bearer or not? He's gonna even fire at Vinny. And of course he missed, because he's disoriented and we have higher grounds, low cover. And he's generally not doing so great. Ulrich, do you want to have another try at this? Do you want to have another try? Let's put you straight in his face. No problem. And just blast him. What's your percentage now? 92%. He's right in front of you. Well, I suppose she, because the Codex for some reason has boots. And she even dodged that for some reason. That was horrible.
Status confirmed. All hostiles are down and the area is secure.
No, they aren't. Are we gonna take that shield bearer to our base or what? Because he's still over there. You can see him on the right there. He's still alive. Don't you want me to club the shield bearer or something? Wow, Ulrich, Edel, Vryer made everything happen. Made most attacks, most under fire, and he moved the furthest. And Christoph dealt most damage with his shotgun. But that's hard to top, of course, unless you get a few in the same grenade. But Ulrich, very well done. Really nicely done this mission. Not the best successful shot percentage, but yeah, it is what it is, I suppose. I think we got at least one promotion, I'm not really sure. I always forget to take a look at that before we finish the mission, but we'll see it anyway. One promotion.
Let's keep it up, Commander.
So, Vinny, what are you going to be? Deadeye or Lightning Hands? I always prefer Lightning Hands, so that's not really a question now, is it? There we go. Thank you.
Commander, please thank our troops for completing what was surely a difficult task in acquiring the Codex Grain. We'll begin work on it as soon as possible.
Well, we apparently got loot from... well, I suppose that's from the... a stock and 2 autoloaders from the shield bearer that was still alive, probably. And now we have 3 Codex brains, so not just one, we have 3 Codex brains. The Codex leaves only this small, nearly featureless brain when it expires, which has proven remarkably resistant to biological or mechanical scans of any kind. A stock, which is actually pretty good, and 2 autoloaders, and the troops of everybody we killed, except for the Codexes, of course, because those are brains. Alien encryption research unlocked. Unlike the conventional encryption methods we would typically encounter with terrestrial data stores, the aliens appear to be using an advanced matrix consisting of both mechanical and biological ciphers, combined with some form of psionic interference. The thought of uncovering the aliens' most complex designs is both intriguing and frightening in equal measure.
Considering the limited resources available to you, Commander, you have still managed to exceed my expectations. Excellent work.
Because we killed the Codex, you can see there in the bottom, we reduced the Avatar progress by 1 and we countered, of course, the dark event. Rapid response because of the guerrilla ops. And we got a scientist, so there we go.
New objective added.
Yeah, new objective added. Complete the alien encryption research. So by
the
researching that brain.
A form of encryption beyond anything we've ever encountered, much less theorized. We'll have to find a means of breaking the code, but I expect it will take some time.
So killing the Codex gave us some respite.
What these recruits lack in experience, they make up for in grit.
Yeah, they do. Let's check the bridge, because I think, if I'm not mistaken, that horrible timer will have disappeared. I hope. I think.
The creature your troops defeated
here was
clearly of some importance to the aliens, Commander. Let us hope that the recovered remains prove equally important to our own efforts.
So we can get some more Avenger power from another thing on the map, which is really good. There's a few things I want to do, actually. So let's get back first and check out... Cedric is still in the med bay, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, there he is. So let's check out the proving grounds. There we go. I think we should go for another experimental grenade, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, let's put that in the queue as well.
I'll send word when the project is complete.
Then I think we don't have any new items in engineering, so we're gonna have to wait until the research is done for that. And let's see. So the timer has disappeared, so we still have a bit of time before we need to do the advent black side. So I do want to start making contact as well, because the more regions we have, the better, of course. The better prepared we are to counter the Avatar project. But I still want that engineer, so we're gonna head there first and then probably start making contact. I'm gonna have to forfeit the Avenger power if that takes too long. So we have Avenger powers, and actually we still have alien alloys left as well, but we still have plenty of those for now, so let's just get that engineer. There we go. Landmark. After smoke began to rise from a nearby landmark, we used our long-range scanners to probe the site. With no immediate indication of hostile activity, we conducted an aerial sweep and found an engineer living in a small settlement nearby who was trying to signal XCOM. Esmeralda Diaz. Thank you very much. Okay, so let's put you to work immediately. Yeah, there we go. And let's put you to work on clearing that power coil over here. Esmeralda Diaz. There we go. Okay, thank you very much. And let's get back to the bridge. So, with that engineer cleared, we could go for the extra power or the alien alloys, but I think it's high time we start making contact with another region. So let's go to Eastern Europe and contact. It should be halved, but 80 intel is pretty steep now, isn't it? Let's go back. How much is it for here? So that's probably gonna... Ooh. Okay. Yeah. I think I'm starting to get what the problem is. We could still make a radio relay. So India connects to two new areas. Eastern Europe connects to two new areas as well. So let's go just for Eastern Europe and get it done that way. So 80 intel.
Commander,
if that's the cost, we're going to do that.
Communications capacity. We can't.
I know we're at capacity, but we're going to fix that with the extra engineers we got now. So make contact. There we go.
Attempting to establish local regional...
Okay, Advent Mech breakdown complete, so let's check that out. From our initial breakdown...
...of these mechanized units out there helping to keep the peace. As far as I can tell, they're fully automated and armed to the teeth.
That's what cost you 6 days to find out. That was bad. From our initial breakdown, I have to assume the Advent Mech design was at least in part based on the alien sector port. A similar autonomous war machine lacking in biological components. As far as I can tell, the Advent variant was supposed to be less intimidating, more suited for urban pacification or peacekeeping operations conducted in proximity to the civilian crowds. That facade only works because of the carefully disguised weapon systems integrated throughout the machine. I don't think people would react so calmly if they knew about the micro-missile launching system linked to Advent's network, running facial recognition on the crowds at microsecond intervals. So there we go. And there's a very interesting project over there, Blue Screen Protocol. And a Gremlin Mark II, that's actually very interesting as well. Didn't know that was an effect of that. So the Mark II Gremlin is an improved version of the standard Gremlin drone. Not only will it greatly increase the hacking stat of our specialists, but many specialist abilities improve their effectiveness when the Gremlin becomes more advanced. There we go, and this one is very interesting. Blue Screen Protocol. With the number of mechanized units Advent has available to throw at us, developing munitions capable of disabling them should be one of our higher priorities. Tygen suggested we look into disrupting their core operating system, and I agree, it's a good place to start. So that's a lot of proving grounds projects. That's gonna take a bit of time, of course, but they're gonna be really, really handy. You know what? 9 days, it's pretty good. We got that extra scientist, and that's probably why 9 days is acceptable. So let's go with that, Illyrium.
I foresee a number of valuable applications stemming from this technology. I'll have a report assembled as soon as the research is complete.
Can I actually cancel? Ooh, I can. Oh, so I can move projects down. That's actually really good. Didn't actually know I could do that, so... Cancel project. What does that actually... I'm not gonna cancel the project. I'm just gonna put in... Wait a second, didn't I? No. Okay, so... Blue Screen Protocol just asks for an Illyrium core as well.
Good, Commander. I'll let you know as soon as the project is ready for deployment.
And now we're finally out of Illyrium cores. Well, not finally. I don't want to be out of Illyrium cores. So let's move project down. And now we have Blue Screen Protocol in 9 days, Plasma Grenades in 3, and Experimental Grenades in 14 days, which is pretty good for now. Let's head to Engineering. And let's see if we can build that advanced
New
Gremlin.
Orders,
ooh, that's actually pretty cheap. So 50 supplies and 5 alien alloys. That is good. So that's increasing our hacking stat tremendously. So if we go to the armory...
Dad sacrificed the only thing he had left to get this ship off the ground. And I won't let it be for nothing. She might be a little worse for wear right now. But with some new schematics and a little elbow grease... She'll be the toughest thing in the sky.
Yeah, she might actually be. So let's check out our soldiers and check out Benito. Because he has the highest hacking stat for now. But look at that. So I think 25 is added because of the Skulljack. But we get another 20 because of our improved Gremlin. So 70 plus 45 is a whopping 115 hacking skill. Which is amazing, by the way. I think it also boosts the damage of other abilities such as combat protocol, so the shock will also have been improved. So let's see what we can actually do to his weapon, because we never actually checked that out. Well, now that we have a few, I'm going to put an autoloader on his weapon, which is going to come in handy against codexes. And then we could add the stock. But I think we should add the stock on lower damaged, well, lower aim guys. So, such as, I think Ulrich doesn't have one yet, or does he? Weapon upgrades. Does he have? He has the expanded magazine, but not the stock. So let's put the stock on there. So missed shots still deal 1 damage. There we go. Because that helped out Geralt in the past, so that might help him out as well. So that's that. Pretty nicely done. A lot of nice upgrades, and now we're going to check the map again and continue making contact. So Cedric has recovered from his wounds. I'm going to actually stop that there then. So that's a plasma grenade, which is really, really good, because now... Ooh, advanced explosives. Now we can use those skills to upgrade our entire arsenal of explosives using the latest technology. What does that do? I'm not actually sure. There's 2 things I want to do. I'm going to remove the engineer from the advanced warfare center. So let's empty that out and put the last engineer at the excavationing. I don't think that's a word, but excavating. There we go. That's the word. And then with that done, no, I was going to check the proving grounds. Game, I was going to check the proving grounds. Don't be too fast. No. Let's go to the right. Yeah, choose project. Advanced explosives. We can use those skills to upgrade our entire arsenal of explosives using the latest technology. I don't know what this does. Does that just upgrade our explosives? Oh, I thought because we researched the plasma grenades that we all had plasma grenades now. So if I go to the armory and check out any random soldier's inventory, I should get plasma grenades, right? Yeah, plasma grenades. So that does 4 to 5 damage. So what seems to be the problem there? If we upgrade that, does that even more damage then? Well, it does sound good, so might as well do that. I'm actually wondering what that does. I'm not really sure. So let's check out edit queue. Cancel project. If I cancel the project, I'm probably gonna get that thingy back, I suppose. So let's get back, choose a project, and now we have, okay. So we have our Illyrium core back, so now we can use that to start advanced explosives. Let's check the map again and continue making contact. And there we go. No aliens in between, apparently. So that's another region, and I think I'm gonna use a bit of supplies to put a radio beacon over there. Because that should help us make it easier to make contact to other areas.
Long live the resistance.
So there we go. New income 70 new supplies.
Regional contacts located.
And Western Europe and East Africa are available. So if I now fire when ready, what was the bonus here? Oh yeah, so proven ground projects are completed instantly. That would be very nice. We have a bit of supplies left, so I might actually go in here and use 50 supplies to install a radio relay and do that immediately. So the power coil is cleared, but I don't think I'm gonna have enough supplies to build. Wait, what the? There should be an option to build a fancier power relay. Oh yeah, never mind. So the power relay is just boosted because of the shielded power coil underneath. But I need 80 supplies and we only have 64. You know what? I'm gonna start clearing out another area. So with 2 engineers, excavate that. Okay. And you know what? Now that... So he put all 3 of the engineers over there. So that's not actually that bad. So 10 days. We should start making that power relay as well. But for now, it's not that bad. So yeah, let's go back to the bridge and finish making that radio relay. There we go. And we have another retaliation site, which is weird. I think we... Another retaliation mission. We just had one, didn't we? But never mind. Let's check it out. And again, New Arctic is under attack.
Setting course.
So the aliens really like to hit our home base. We're gonna have to take them out again. Novgorod, I presume. Operation Death Father. Very difficult, but we have a nice bit of upgrades over here. What are we gonna do? I'm gonna switch out Vinny for Cedric again. I'm gonna make his armor available and put that back on Cedric, of course. And that only gives him a plasma grenade and I don't think anything else. Yeah, there we go. Could put a weapon upgrade on that. Oh yes, because we have an advanced autoloader available now. So let's put that on the sniper rifle. Yep, there we go. We do have another scope as well. Why do we... No. Scope is what is installed on this weapon. We actually have another autoloader available, and I'm thinking about removing the trigger on Christoph's weapon. Because if we can give him a free reload, that would be amazing. So, weapon upgrades. Remove the hair trigger because it only fired once so far, so let's just do that and put an autoloader on there. There we go, hair trigger is destroyed, but we get an autoloader. And then, I'm pretty happy with the way we're looking right now. But I'm wondering if we should get another Ranger. If we should get Jazz Gypsy in there. I think I might actually do that. Although with the improved grenades, it's a very difficult mission, so we don't want to take any chances. So yeah, let's do it like that. So next up, we're gonna do another retaliation mission, Operation Deathfather. We're gonna have to wait with the black side because we reduced the avatar timer with one. So that was really great. So next up, retaliation. We're gonna have to save a lot of civilians again. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Yeah, bye.